can't stop us, not even our silly little fears of making our first connection call. So there I was, 22 years old, 9 months into the business, and I was scared to death to make a phone call. Yes, I said it, 9 months. I had rehearsed and asked my upline a million questions. And of course, he graciously gave me advice. I had my phone in my hand and my prospect's number ready to dial. And I was pacing back and forth, just chanting to myself, "You can do it. You've got this. You can do this, Jess." Just hit the call. And after several long, grueling minutes of this, I finally pushed the call button with some seriously sweaty palms. Then a new chant began. This one maybe not quite as positive. It went a little something like this. "Please don't answer. Please don't answer. Please don't answer. Oh, hey, David. Hey, answer. Now what?" I remember stumbling over my words, repeating myself, not making a bit of sense. And when I finally arrived at the question, it took all I had not to answer it. But I did what I was supposed to do. I called my upline. And before giving any details, I merged the call. And I gave the best introduction I could think of. "Hey, Megan, it is Luke." And I'm muted a lot. By the way, it's not what you want to do. But what I want you to get from this is this. The support is readily available. There are leaders all over this room wanting us to reach out, wanting you to ask them for advice and take it. You just have to ask. Guys, we have incredible tools that they launched this weekend, and I hope you agree with that. Some concepts of ZIJA International have done an incredible job with our tools. Woo! It is simply up to us to go out of this conference and start using them. And guys, whether it's the social media book that Brina and I had a chance to give a little insight on, or it's giving a really awesome oily massage, like I said, it's up to you to just use it. But the best part is that we have a message that is so strong and so clear that it alone does the hard work for us. And so, guys, I'm asking you to take action. Yeah, and there's a man in my life that has supported me and taught me many things. He's been my rock and my biggest support. And so, Brandon, I want to thank you for believing in me and encouraging me to be the best person that I can be. And more than that, for always believing in ZIJA Nation. So, guys, where does your hard work take you? Don't let fear keep you from your end game. Together, let's go share the natural health revolution.
Who's fired up? Man, some of y'all don't believe yourself. Listen, you can jack up, excited, out of your mind to go share the National Health Revolution. I'm reminded of the story of the young shepherd boy, and you probably know the story. Most of you know it pretty well. David, as he was facing the Philistine army, he saw things a little bit differently than his fellow countrymen. He had a divine perspective, is what I call it. And he began to realize who we are, as David did, began to realize that his fear and doubt no longer paralyzed him like it did everyone else. Even the king and the mightiest Israelite warriors, they were fearful to face a giant named Goliath. I think there's two things that helped David defeat that giant. Number one, David knew that God was on his side, and he was the one that was truly fighting the battle for David. He had a bulletproof mindset because of this. He even said to Goliath, he said, "This very day, the Lord will give you to us." He knew the end of the story. You see, I want to help you get the picture right. Because when you get the picture right, then you can begin to realize that you can win. His visualization was so clear and distinct that he boldly proclaimed to the giant. He said to Goliath, "On this day, the Lord will deliver you into my hands and I will strike you and take from you your head. Number two, David had a cause. If he didn't kill Goliath and they didn't win the battle, well, guess what? The Philistines would kill them all anyway. They would plunder the city. They would rape their wives. They would enslave their children. And so there was no option but to fight and to win. You with me? Retreat was not an option. You can almost hear David as he's passionately explaining to the Israelites why everyone is murmuring and giving excuses as to why they shouldn't have to fight. He shouts, "Have we not a cause?" I'd like to pose that same question to you, ZIJA Nation. Have we not a cause? I think the answer is a resounding yes. Thankfully, we live in a time that's a little bit different. We don't have big giants chasing us around that are seeking to kill us, but the giants that we face are a little bit different. We face the giants of a broken food system, a broken economic system, a broken families and broken homes, societies that willingly perpetuate disease. I'm here to tell you that just like with David, we have no option but to fight and to win. It is mandatory. I'm also here to tell you that just like with David, this is a divine mission. It's part of a divine nature. In fact, if you know the origins of the story, our Abraham himself actually said that he was divinely inspired and spiritually prompted to start this revolution from the very beginning. There's a great awakening happening inside of ZIJA Nation. You can feel it. You can sense it. I know you can. And I know you came here this weekend looking for some answers. And I'm here to tell you that the answer is inside of you. You are the answer. This natural health revolution is a message that is so critical to saving millions of lives, both physically and financially. It's been spawned by Dr. Joshua Plant. Revolutionaries like Ryan Palmer and Tara Dasker. It's been made possible by our founder, Mr. Ken Brelsford. But the real revolutionaries are me and you. The battle must be fought by me and you, by each of us, together. We have to take action. We've got to do the deal. We have to move. We've got to do whatever it takes to set the captives free. We've got to be highly committed so that millions of others all across the globe can go out and pursue and achieve their own version of life unlimited, whatever it means to them. There are people you don't even know right this very minute that are literally on their knees praying and begging for the opportunity that you need to share with them, like ZIJA, to come bless their lives. We've got to do everything in our power. We've got to turn over every rock on planet Earth. We've got to do whatever it takes to find every single last one of them, guys. And I'll spend the rest of my life doing that. We've got to be highly committed to doing whatever it takes. Are you with me? You hear what I'm saying? I picture David as he grew into the man after God's own heart, as the scripture calls him. And I can picture him with all his faults. And I can see him with all of his many failures. And despite all that, he forged a path and maybe more than any other single individual in history helped design the destiny of a nation and helped forge the path for a group of wanderers out of the desert to go on and create one of the greatest nations and success stories on the planet. The chosen one, the one that would one day burst the networker and revolutionary of history. I know you have doubts and I know you have fears. I know you've got baggage and made mistakes in the past, but I don't care about your past. I care about your future. Where are you headed? It's okay to look back. Just don't stare. You're God's highest form of creation. There's seeds of greatness in you, but you've got to cultivate the seeds. The only thing that can kill doubt is faith. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not yet seen. The only thing that cures fear is action. Action supersedes everything. Do the thing that you fear, and the death of fear is certain. At the end of the day, after everything's been said and done, let's just be sure more is done than said. See, God feeds the birds every single morning, but he does not shove the worm down their throat. Good things may come to those who wait, but only the things left by those who hustle. You see, we do play a part. We've got to make a move. Even the Almighty says, if you move towards me, then I'll move towards you. A man had an old rock pile turned into a beautiful garden. His friend walked by one day and said, "You're the good Lord. You've got a beautiful garden here." And he said, "I understand your point. But you should have seen it when the good Lord had it all to himself." We have to take action. As I close here today, I'd like to ask you all to make two commitments with me as we're here in this moment. Can we do that, ZIJA Nation? If you're committed to doing what it takes to go to God, let me hear you say, "I am."
I am.
All right. I'm going to give you two commitments that I've made. And I know all these other ladies down here have made as well, to help them go God and beyond. And the number one commitment is this. Never let anyone outwork you. Number two is this. Never let anyone outlast you. If you will commit to a relentless pursuit and all-out assault on the status quo, I'm telling you, your family can live a life unparalleled by the masses and unmatched by the classes. And it will dramatically improve the trajectory of your family's future. Who's on board with that? I'd like to leave you with one of my favorite mantras. In fact, I read it often. It's called the Fellowship of the 2%. And if you listen closely, you will find within it the secrets of what it truly takes to win in this business and win in life. Now I'm going to ask you, if you join me, I'd like for you to stand for just a moment. I'll give you 2 seconds. So I want you to participate here with me. If you need to close your eyes, if you need to scream and shout, do whatever you got to do to drown out the noise and remove distractions for the next 2 minutes. I invite you to join me in this very special and very elite group, ZIJA Nation, the Fellowship of the 2%. I'm a part of the Fellowship of the 2%. The die has been cast. I stepped out of the comfort zone. The decision has been made. I am a diamond. I won't look back, let up, slow down, or back away. My past is forgotten. My present is focused. I'm finished and done with low living, sidewalking, cheap excuses, and dwarf goals. I no longer need preeminence, position, promotion, promises, or even popularity. I don't have to be first. I don't have to be right. I don't have to be recognized. I don't have to be praised, regarded, or rewarded. I've died a self-centered, ego-driven, limp-lip lifestyle. I live by faith. I learn by submitting, labor by love, lead by example, and I live by prayer. My dream is developed. My decision is definite. My desire determined. My discipline dedicated, and my devotion is distinct. My face is set. My pace is fast, and my road is narrow. My way is tough, my companions are strong, but my counselors are reliable. My purpose is pure and my mission is clear. I cannot be bought, compromised, detoured, blurred away, delimited, or denied. I will not flinch in the face of sacrifice, hesitate in the presence of the adversary, negotiate at the table of the enemy, ponder in the pool of popularity, or meander in the maze of mediocrity. I won't give up, let up, shut up until I stayed up, stored up, prayed up, paid up, and stood up. Fellowship of the 2%. Thank you, ZIJA Nation, and God bless.